look outside the... Okay, welcome back. So today we're using a different camera because my phone is just not uploading the videos anymore. So I don't know. Maybe I need a new phone. I don't know if I can justify that for just doing videos. But anyways, yeah, as you notice, I'm using a lot of Third Day music here lately, and because I really enjoy that. But you know, if you have a preference, just go ahead and put it in the comments below. Say, hey, I'd like to hear some Petra, or I'd like to hear some DC Talk, or, you know, but make sure it's something I like. I'm just teasing. Hey, so last video, we did an advertisement about the Gospel Tidings, and we advertised it for $65 a year, but I found an avenue that I can actually print these a lot cheaper now, and so we're going to go ahead and do it for $38 for the whole year. It's a huge discount compared to what we were doing. So if anybody wants to get the monthly publication every month and you're not one of our ministers, then just go ahead and send us a check, or you can go through PayPal, through our website, whatever you want to do. It's pretty exciting to get this every month and see all the different articles. 90% of our ministers, or the people that are involved with us, are ministers, and they get it for free. And so if you decide you might want to become a minister through PEC, just contact us through our website and email us and kind of find out, you know, what it's all about, and we can help you out. And like 90% of our ministers are lay ministers too. They don't have churches. And so the people out there that want to become a minister so they can go into prisons, hospitals, things like that. But anyways, that's enough with that. I want to say that I heard from one of our ministers today. Her name is Mildred Jose from Florida. And she spoke a word into my life today. And I take those as much as what the Lord will tell me. But this was really strong. She said the Lord is going to break a stronghold in our life. And if you don't know, if you don't, you haven't been getting the Gospel Tidings, you know that the military is trying to kick me out 6 months before I retire because of a medical issue. And it's not only wrong, it's just unethical. I put in 19 and a half years, and for them to try to cut me loose at this point in time is crazy. And because I won't get any medical retirement, I won't get an ID card, and all they're going to give me is $192 a month. And if I retire fully, then I get $2,500 a month. So you can see how that's totally unethical, the way the Army's, you know, trying to do their shenanigan thing. And so Mildred had called me and told me that the Lord is going to break that stronghold and allow me to retire. And she says, you're going to get everything that's due. So I'm going to accept that, and I'm pretty excited about that. And so, so today we're going to continue our study of the 100. And Abraham, now I've done this already two times, and it didn't upload. I'm using a different camera now, and I'm actually using a video camera. So we're going to, I'm going to hope and pray this goes through. But I should know what I'm talking about after I've preached this two times already. And so, but what we're going to do is I'm going to, there's 9 points I'm going to touch on. We're going to talk about the meaning behind the name Abraham, which his name was actually Abram when he first started out. Who he was, when he was born, where he lived, his parents, his lies that he told, the name change, and the declaration of him being the father of nations, God's promise to him about a son, and the test that God put him through. So Abram's name may be viewed either in meaning of father of many. It is a Hebrew, and but it's in connection of Abram. And so most likely it means many or multitude. He is also considered the father of faith. And as you study about him, and I've done a lot of studying on Abraham, you can tell that he was a very faithful man. He was a biblical patriarch, and you know, with his name originally being Abram. And according to If you go into Genesis chapter 17, verse 5, you'll find that. Now, Abram was born in 1996, but not 80, of course. It was in B.C., so he was born, you know, over 4,000 years ago. And according to Genesis 25, 7, he lived for 175 years. Can you imagine what we could get done in the kingdom of God to live 175 years? As long as we were good to go, you know, we had good health and we weren't living in a rest home for 75 of those years. You know, I could get so much done in 175 years. And so in his early years, Abraham lived in Mesopotamia. I don't know if that's how I'm saying it right, but it should be right around here. Okay. And before he moved into the promised land. And so, his mother is never really mentioned in the Bible, but there's only a hint about it in the Torah, okay? Now, if his father, his name was Terah, T-E-R-A-H, which he was an idol worshiper, believe it or not. It's pretty amazing. You're going to find there was a lot of people in the Bible that were mighty people for God, but their background was evil. And Abram was no different in this way. And when his father was 70 years old, Abraham was born. So you can see that there's a little pattern going on there. In Genesis 12, verses 10 through 20, I'm not going to read it all, but Abraham and his wife went to Egypt to live before, but before they got there, Abraham had told his wife to lie about who she was and to say that she was his sister, because and during that time he was really afraid that when they got to Egypt that these people were, because she was a very beautiful lady, they would kill him and take her for their wife, being that the fact that she was considered a sister, they would just take her, and so normally most likely would pay him for her. And so they did this and things didn't go so well. And you can read a little bit about that. But he got the king that took her saying, "Hey, why'd you lie to us? You know, all that, you brought all this evil down on us." And then he does it again in chapter 20. And like when we were reading about this, I was telling Anna, my wife, about it. She's like, "Yeah, he was a jerk. You know, he should protect his wife." And you know, I agree. You know, he should have done the upright thing instead of trying to protect himself, because that's basically what he did, was just protecting himself. He wasn't thinking of his wife. But you know what? He did redeem himself. God still used him as the father of nations. And, you know, in Genesis 17, Abraham was 99 when God told him they were going to have a baby and declared his name as Abraham. He changed his name at the age of 99. And so when God told him and Sarah that they were going to have a son at that age, they laughed. They chuckled to themselves. And God saw that as a disrespect. The thing is before that, they had Sarah gave her maidservant Hagar to Abraham so that he could have a son through her. And his name was Ishmael. And we'll talk about Ishmael later, but years later, you know, about 10 years later, that when they had Isaac, the Bible says that Abraham loved Isaac more than any other. And so because of this, God wanted to test Abraham and find out how much he loved him. So he had, if you remember right, they went up on the mountain to do a sacrifice, and Isaac had even asked his father, where's our sacrifice? And he said, "The Lord's going to provide." So they get up there, and he bounds him, and he goes to kill him, and God stops him in time. But, you know, Abraham would have. He would have killed his beloved son because he loved God more than he loved Isaac. And so God provided what they, some versions say it was a ram, some say it was a goat, or not a goat, but God provided a sacrifice, bottom line. And so this really, you know, when you look at the story, God provided a sacrifice so that Abraham didn't have to give up his son. We look at what God had provided so that we wouldn't have to continually sacrifice. And that's, he gave up his only begotten son. And so I just wanted to, you know, bring this out. Abraham's, there's a ton of information about Abraham in the Bible. And we're going to find when we go start, you know, looking at, into the other people, that there's not so much in there. But we do know that Abraham was the father of many nations, and that he, you know, really brought together what we're looking at for today. He was really a great example. Yeah, he messed up. We all do. And you're, when you start studying, if you study all 100, like I'm writing a book, almost done, and I've had to actually kind of go back and look at what I've written. I've already written about 90 characters, and as I've been reading and researching these people, they all messed up. They all had some issue. You know, there's very few that didn't have an issue. And but we do know that as we walk through our walk with God, we're going to make mistakes. But He is gracious, and He is full. He's full of mercy, and He'll forgive. Anyways, hey, this was a great one. We'll talk at you later, and God bless.